A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 9th August, on the front page you have statehood for Jammu and Kashmir will be restored, Prime Minister. So Prime Minister Narendra Modi has promised now that statehood would be restored when situation becomes so, and he also promised more investment, jobs and pay parity for Jammu and Kashmir and Ladakh. Here it's been 2 days after Article 370 has been scrapped down and the reorganization of Jammu and Kashmir into separate union territories took place. Prime Minister Narendra Modi addressed the nation, a televised address was relayed, and he called it a historic move and a new beginning for Jammu and Kashmir as well as Ladakh. Then you have Bharat Ratna awarded to Pranab Mukherjee. So, former President of India Pranab Mukherjee and even late BJP Bharatiya Jansang ideologue Nanaji Deshmukh and late singer Bhupen Hazarika, they have been conferred with Bharat Ratna, which is highest civilian honor in India. So, it's the highest civilian award. So President Ramnath Kovind gave this award to his predecessor Pranab Mukherjee and two others posthumously. On page 7, you have Maharashtra to set up task force on climate change. So, because of unprecedented rainfall, which we have seen creating a flood-like situation in various regions of Maharashtra, the state government now will constitute a task force of local and global experts to study impact of climate change on Mumbai especially. So, this task force will study measures taken against flooding and unplanned reclamation in cities like Venice, Geneva and London, and coordinate with even European climate change program of the European Union to prepare a blueprint. Below you have Asian Development Bank to give $200 million aid for state's rural road project. So this is for Maharashtra state. So this is $200 million loan for improving road infrastructure in 34 districts in Maharashtra for better connectivity of rural areas with markets and services. On page 9 you have, can Janmasthan be a juristic person? Asked the Supreme Court. So, this is the third day of hearing of the Ram Janmabhoomi Babri Masjid land dispute case, and Supreme Court has asked whether birthplace or Janmasthan can be regarded as a juristic person. So, you should know this is 5-judge constitutional bench which is hearing this case, and this is in context of Ram Lalla Virajman, which is one of the parties in the case. So, a question on this juristic person is raised by Supreme Court. On the editorial page, the first editorial is knee-jerk. So this is regarding Pakistan, how it has taken a knee-jerk reaction to India's decision to scrap Article 370 and divide Jammu and Kashmir into two union territories. So the editorial says that Pakistan must reconsider its decision to downgrade diplomatic ties with India. And below you have cycle of extremes. So this is regarding how India is crippling under cycles of drought and flood. So it must address these issues with redoubled vigor. We are facing both drought-like situations and now when rainfall arrives, flood-like situations. And this is economic milestone and a pregnant anniversary. So this is regarding bank nationalization. So it says that bank nationalization eased rural credit and aided financial inclusion. And it says any move to reverse it would be self-defeating. So the benefits of bank nationalization, which was undertaken by former Prime Minister Indira Gandhi, that is discussed here. So that was the last nationalization process undertaken. Then this is a leaf out of the Chinese playbook. So this is regarding India's actions in Kashmir. So it says this increasingly shows an authoritarian muscularity reminiscent of China, the way China takes action against its regions. Then on the op-ed page, you have this coverage which is there on every Friday, Parley coverage, in which a question is raised and view counter view given. So it says, does the Medical Commission Bill encourage quackery? So quackery basically is quacks, who are people posing as doctors, who are not actually doctors. So in the Medical Commission Bill earlier version, we had seen even there was a mention of bridge course, which would allow non-MBBS students, means BUMS, BAMS, BHMS, means Ayurveda, Unani, homeopathy graduates, they can practice allopathic medicine, MBBS medicine with a bridge course. So that had become very controversial and that provision has been dropped. But still the Medical Commission Bill talks of how non-MBBS doctors can be, you know, trained and can be used in rural areas. So of course there is a shortage of allopathic doctors, particularly in rural areas. But is this the right approach or would this increase quackery is the question being raised. Here you can see this is regarding Article 370 now. Again, on page 12 you have changes in PMLA Act empower Enforcement Directorate. So this is Prevention of Money Laundering Act. So the center has issued notification on certain changes in this act, like, you know, how to treat money laundering as a standalone crime is mentioned here, and also the ambit of proceeds of crime has been extended to assets that may have been derived from any other criminal activity related to scheduled offenses. So this is said to be enhancing the powers of the investigating agency, the Enforcement Directorate. Also, prior chargeship by any other investigating agency is not required in PMLA cases. Now, otherwise money laundering had to be linked to a particular criminal offense. Now it is a standalone offense. Then on page 13 you have Pakistan airspace curbs will not have much impact, says Air India. So Air India says that partial airspace restriction has been imposed by Pakistan in its present form. It requires only its flights to make a 12-minute detour. So it will not have much impact. And below you have Pakistan will stop Samjhota services, says minister. So Pakistan's railway minister said that Islamabad, that is Pakistan, has decided to stop the Samjhota Express train service immediately in response to India's decision to change the status of Jammu and Kashmir. And you can see Samjhota Express, it runs between Lahore and Attari. It connects India and Pakistan through this rail line, and Attari is in turn connected to Delhi via link train. On international page you have Syria rejects Turkey-US plan. Kurds give guarded welcome. So this is regarding this US-Turkey plan in Syria, in which a plan is for a US-Turkish buffer zone for northern Syria. So this is saying that this is because of aggressive project on Syria's Kurds. So you can see Syria has strongly rejected this proposal. While the proposal has been given a guarded welcome by Kurds in Syria. And this is China decries US ban on its firms. So Huawei and other Chinese firms have been banned by USA. So this is an issue being raised by China now. And this is food supplies at dire risk. So United Nations says 500 million people live in places that are turning into deserts. So food security is a concern now across the globe. On business page you have mutual fund SIPs, that is systematic investment plans, at 3-year high. So net retail inflow for July is almost double on a month-to-month basis. And this is no action even if CSR norms are not followed. So this is the assurance given by the government. So if companies are not following the corporate social responsibility CSR norms, they would not be having punitive action taken against them, as has been mentioned in the recent amendment in the Companies Act. So this assurance has been given by the finance minister. And this is Central Board of Direct Taxes eases plight of startups with pending angel tax cases. So CBDT has issued clarification instructing its officers that registered companies that have already been selected for verification under angel tax provisions will not be scrutinized and their defense will be accepted summarily. Then on the last page you have Indian soil may have reached moon on crashed Israeli lander. So this is, you can see, a tiny biological sample from India, it is said, may have already landed on the moon ahead of Chandrayaan 2. So it was Israeli lander called Bereshit, which means beginning in Hebrew language. So it began its journey to the moon aboard a SpaceX rocket. And this is the first privately funded spacecraft to land on the moon. So it is carrying a lunar library, which includes a leaf from the Bodhi tree. So biological samples and Indian soil may have reached moon on this crashed Israeli lander. So Bereshit has crash landed on moon surface. Then here you can see the details of the Lunar Library, which is a 30 million page archive of human history and civilization covering all subjects. So that has reached the moon now. And below you have, at sites, India to seek boost to protection status of 5 species. So India has submitted proposals regarding changes to the listing of various wildlife species in sites. That is Convention on International Trade in Endangered Species on Wild Fauna and Flora. So it had sites meeting was held in Geneva, Switzerland. So India has put forth its proposal. So it's an international treaty, as the name suggests, on trade in wild animals and plants, that they should not threaten their survival. So India has proposed changes in the listing of 5 species, that is smooth-coated otter, small-clawed otter, Indian star tortoise, and also others like, you know, toke gecko, wedge fish, and Indian rosewood. The country, India, seeks to boost the protection of all the 5 animal species that are facing high risk of international trade. And Indian rosewood is a faunal species, a floral species, that is a plant species. So India's proposal is to remove it from the species under CITES appendix 2. So there are 3 appendices in CITES, you should know, on the degree of protection that the species require. So, India wants the relisting of star tortoise from Appendix 2 to Appendix 1, calling for more protection for it. That is detailed out here. And this is Museum of Sikhism sets new record. So, this is Virasat-e-Khalsa Museum in Punjab's Anandpur Sahib town. And it has been put in Asia Book of Records for becoming the most visited museum in the Indian subcontinent in a single day. So this is Virasat-e-Khalsa. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website asr.com. Thank you.